Hi, everyone. With Eddie Olczyk and Ray Ferraro shortly, I'm Mike Emery. Terrific action lies ahead. We are looking forward to all of this. October, first month of the hockey year, and a great time for a strong start to the season. Face-off about to take place, but first, these words from Eddie Olczyk.
The fans are on their feet supporting their team, celebrating the start of regular season play. This is playoff atmosphere in game number one.
The players are more than set. They have gotten through the preseason, they've made the team, and they're ready to make an impact. We are ready as well to start off game number one of the regular season. And it has begun. Capel to Drew in. Pitching it to Weber. Oh, and that is a hit to Hurt, the first of many.
One-on-one. Abrams score!
Boy, they're on the board early, aren't they?
Now that the scoring's been opened up, we'll see if the opponent can punch their way back into this game. You can't be back on your heels too long.
Montreal's got the first one.
Boy, I saw this coming. They had the momentum.
The Leafs with a win at center. A shot. Missed. Solid work there by Pacioretty.
What a heavy hit.
Well, we expected a physical game, Doc, and it looks like he's on a mission trying to set the tone for his team early in the first period.
Pitching this one to Nylander. Cut off that pass in the neutral zone. Petrie's got it on his stick, trying to get it out of there. Pass attempt to Drew in.
Oh, what a hit that one was.
One way to wear down your opponent, play physical. That's exactly what happened there.
And he steps across the line.
Good save there.
Passing one off now to Domi.
Great defensive job. What a hit.
Oh, he got crushed. Absolutely steamrolled in the middle of the ice. It's like he didn't see the player coming. The first time he sensed the danger, he was on his back. Domi's shaken up. He's gone straight to the dressing room with the trainer. The doctors will meet him there. This is a suspected head injury. They'll all convene in the quiet room.
Toronto's got that faceoff win. Hainsey's tripped up. That should be a penalty. Montreal's given a minor here for tripping.
Oh, this is clearly a tripping call. He made no attempt to play the puck and took the legs out from the attacking player.
The Leafs are activating their power play unit for the first time.
Well, the power play's excited to get out there. Those guys just about scrambled onto the ice as they get their initial chance of this game.
Side to side they go, trying to generate something.
Pressed in between his pads, play is stopped.
Toronto's got that win.
Glanced it off the crossbar.
Routine play, done well. Toronto's got time for only this rush. Snapping a pass to Matthews. The Canadiens have us back at full strength because the penalty has been killed.
Frustration starts to seep in here, guys, when you miss a power play at a key juncture of the game like that. This is a chance to tie the game. They don't execute it very well.
Say, Petrie's tripped and a penalty should be coming. The Leafs are boxed on a tripping minor.
I'm going to give credit to the puck carrier here. He kept his legs moving. He forced the back checker to reach in and take him off his feet.
The Canadiens are hoping to get one out of one on the power play.
You can turn the tide of a game on a power play, whether you score or not, by getting shots, by getting traffic, and by keeping the puck in the offensive zone. If you chase it up and down the ice all the time, nothing gets accomplished.
A great speed bump set up there. Wants the shelter of the corner here.
from the outside. Great save. Toronto's killed it off. Full strength action now.
Well, they certainly weren't going to score, guys, with the way that they set that power play up to stationary. They didn't shoot the puck. They didn't have any traffic.
Oh, looking for a penalty call on that one. Price has made it to the bench. Extra players on. Shoots one. The Maple Leafs lose a man for 2 minutes for charging.
Too many strides taken, Doc, while making contact.
The Canadiens' power play gets another chance to operate. Hasn't been effective yet.
After an ineffective power play earlier in the game, let's see if they can get a little more organized, get the puck into the zone and get it on net far more frequently.
Gathered up again by Petrie.
What a hit that was!
Riley's not shy to throw his body around here at any time.
That shot came from right in front.
That was a tougher stop than a look.
Looking to Brown. Toronto's done a remarkable job of killing off the penalty, back at full strength.
Some power plays are more important than others, and when you're in a position in the game like this, it would be nice to come through. They just didn't seem to have any set plan about what they were trying to accomplish on that power play.
This is frustrating. The goaltender makes a save by getting just a chunk of the shot.
We go down to the benches. It's Ray Ferraro.
Just spoke to a representative from the road team. They're going to be short a player for the rest of the night. The injured player won't come back.
An open ice collision. Wow, look at him. He's got a long way to go. Does he have enough gas? Quick shot. Save there. Slid to Gallagher. He cut that one off in the defensive end. Off his pad. Takes it in from the neutral zone. And a save. And now it's directed to Shaw. Trying to go to Petrie.
Cut that pass in his own end.
Shoots it on.
Made that work for him in goal.
To Deneau.
In the first period.
And the players collide in open ice. Puts on the moves out front.
Moving it to Matthews.
The whistle signals an offside.
You can't deliver the puck much better than that, but the goalie says no chance. That's an excellent save.
The faceoff, the tie-up, and a solid job from the winger there.
20 minutes are in the books, and so the coaches will have their say. The players will rest and listen.
Only one goal scored, and 2 periods yet to go.
Hey, kids, don't forget if you're a member of our rookie team.
The Canadiens got their lead in this game what seems like a long time ago. I guess because it was. But they do have that lead as we head to break. 20 minutes in the books, 20 minutes ahead. And so what did you think of the first?
The Maple Leafs are down only by one, Doc, and they're lucky. The way they turned over the puck in that first period, this could easily be a 3 or 4 goal deficit.
And the middle frame has begun. A point blast! Wonderful stop! He imposed his will. Just a backhand.
That puck hit him on the way to the net.
Puck is thrown to Petrie.
Skates it into the zone.
I like the way that he's played tonight. He's been up on his toes trying to make a contribution physically all over the ice. This is an excellent game for him.
Good save. It's going to have to be something tougher than that to score.
Drouin's down again. He has been corked numerous times.
Great stick. No chance on that pass.
Shoots! Terrific save there. Didn't look like he had anything to shoot at, and he made it tough.
The shooter thought he had a chance, but the goaltender robs him. What a stop.
Outstanding save made off a terrific chance.
The Canadiens are skating it up in neutral ice.
Things are heating up with that hit.
Well, he's been looking for that hit all night.
Smart recovery by Kadri.
Outstanding glove save.
And so we've been on the receiving end of more than a few of these things. This is why you retire from the game. What a gorgeous hit.
Under 6 minutes play, the Canadians lead 1-0. Face-off win here. You could almost count that one, but no, what a save. Finished his check right in the middle of the ice.
After that hit there, Doc, we better tighten up our chin straps.
Directing that one to Shaw. Oh, what a mean, mean hit that one was. That's probably going to bring an answer. The whistle signals stoppage of play and we'll get the penalty. Both teams get a minor penalty.
He's calling both, Doc. He's got them both going to the box.
So now, with the penalty box a little occupied, this is going to be 4-on-4.
The open ice leads to some great scoring chances 4-on-4. You get a defenseman into the rush. If you don't score, the other team's guaranteed a 2-on-1 going back the other way. Schlemko's nicked up here. Guys, he's going to have to finish this shift. They're stuck in their own zone.
Toronto's coaching staff is going to have to adjust. A game misconduct has been handed out.
The power play is all about adjustments. They need to find a way to get more people and pucks to the net.
I sure agree, Eddie.
He better be careful. This is multiple penalties again tonight. If you continue to take penalties like this, you're going to find yourself parked in the middle of the bench. 56
seconds. Can start the attack going in the zone. Save. He hangs on and gets the whistle.
Anderson's in position to use his stick here to make a save on a shot that doesn't challenge him that much.
They won that draw. Got the save there. Backhander to the net. And ring more bells on that one. One after another. A big collision in the middle of the ice. Can he beat him here?
Pitching it to Brown.
Moves up the wing. A slot wrister. To Weber. What a marvelous collision. Unless you're in it by himself. Brings it off the post.
Deno's not going to get too many more chances that look like that. Him and the goaltender all alone, and the puck just hits the pipe.
Big save with a glove. I think it changed direction there. In with it now. Fires a shot. Great save. The Canadiens' power play is over. It has been empty for the night and a lot of chances.
This is a brutal formula to try and stay in the game here. They've been shorthanded so many times, yet their penalty killers have answered the call every single time.
A great wrist shot. Save there. All a part of generating an offense. Little pass off from the goal. Shoots one. Great bad stop. And decides to just cover it out and get the whistle.
Goalies have to make a half a dozen great stops in a win. This is one on a beautiful move, but there is nowhere for the puck to go.
Hey, Ray, what's going on down there?
Schlemko's injury is going to keep him out from the rest of the game. He will not return.
Won that faceoff. Now what? Perfect pass. Shoots. He scores.
You want to score goals, you've got to get to this area of the ice.
Everybody loves those, the ones where the water bottle's just about to get shaken. That's a perfect shot right in the top of the net.
The Canadians have scored here late in the second period, and now it is 2-0. So finally, their big advantage in time of possession is rewarded.
Number 54, Charles.
pitching this one to Armia. Pass attempt to Ouellette.
Look out, the hits are coming.
Well, that one's going to rattle you around. You get hit with nowhere to lean against the boards. That one hurts.
Passing one off now to Nylander.
Steps across that line. May not have intended it, but it hit him.
Flips that wrist shot.
And a save. Makes the stop and holds for the whistle.
You can't deliver the puck much better than that, but the goalie said no chance. That's an excellent save. Price has been under siege almost the entire night, but he has stopped just about everything thrown his way. His team's leading this game as a result of his brilliant play and some timely goals.
They won that draw. Took care of that one. Really solid job done defensively. That takes some of the pressure off when you can use your stick like that. Robbery there.
Anderson's done just about everything he can in goal. He's stopped a multitude of excellent opportunities. His team just can't keep up.
Tonight is our team poster giveaway. If you find a sticker on the inside cover of your program, go to get...
The Canadiens collected an insurance goal very late in the period. A real bonus for them. They'll talk it over as we go to break. Third period about to begin. The rearview mirror will help us with the first two, and so will Edza.
Toronto's got a real tough task ahead of them as we get ready for the third period. They know they're facing a hot goaltender. They know they've created a lot of chances. They need a bounce. They need to get a greasy goal. In order to do that, you've got to put yourself right in front of the goaltender.
Snapping a pass to Nylander.
Good shooting place. Off target goes wide. Oh, my, what a hit.
I once had a coach tell me, hit or be hit. There's an example of getting yourself into the game.
Did what he's paid to do. And freezes play for the whistle.
Pretty run-of-the-mill stop for the goaltender. He's got a clean look. It's a shot without much velocity.
They won that battle in the dots. He was standing in the lane and caught some of it. Intercepts that pass. Maybe he can generate something. Two on one. Oh, did he ever get hit? I don't know how many times that is tonight, but he's been targeted. Got that pass in his own end.
And so here comes the whistle for an icing.
Gardner's not out of position at all here. He's in the right spot. That allows him to deliver this chip.
A little under 4 minutes skated here in the third. Two goals have been scored, both by one team. The Leafs through the neutral zone controlling play now.
Twist one.
Gathered up again by Petrie.
An enormous hit.
And a save. Knife down out of the air, looking to Shaw. Terrific hit slowing them down. Heavy hit right in the middle of the ice.
That is a massive open ice hit. They look spectacular. They feel great when you deliver them. They don't feel so great when you're lying where he is.
He wore that puck on a hard shot.
Shifts to the backhand and shoots.
Terrific determination by Petrie.
Now it's directed to Deneau.
Two guys together with force. Big force.
Oh, I like that one. That's a clean hit.
Recollected. A superb hit. A great hockey play there.
Weber's not going to be too happy with that. He didn't have his head up, wasn't aware of everybody around him, and then he got steamrolled. Not sure who made the hit, but that is a big one.
Very effective defensive play. Stole that pass away in his own end. With a strong wrist shot. Score! They're back to within one.
Johnson's quick flick of the wrist put this puck in from the high slot.
Absolutely a great shot, Edzo, but the goaltender dropped down just a bit quick, left the top of the net exposed.
The Maple Leafs are now back to within one with the scoring of that goal. And there's plenty of time for one more goal in the third. Toronto's got that puck off the tie-up.
Good work there in goal. And he holds on, and the whistle stops play.
And yet again, here is Ray Ferraro.
Price is almost able to exhale. He's been outstanding throughout. His team has now stretched the game out offensively. Can't ask for much more than what we're seeing right here.
He has been spectacular in goal tonight. Absolutely, Ray. Thank you. Montreal's prevailed on another faceoff. Huge hit. Shuts that offense right off. Breakaway.
Enormous save on a breakaway kingpin. Got that pass in his own end.
And it's cleared out of there.
And that puck is iced, and so back it will come for another faceoff.
The Senators are not a team to be taken lightly, Doc. They're up next on the schedule, and of course, we'll be calling all the action. Some great, exciting hockey games ahead.
A little under 8 minutes remaining in the period. Toronto's back to within one in this game. Big hit, possession gone.
Thought he had 10 feet of clean ice. He only had five. There's the stop sign.
What a reaction save.
A timely save. That is tremendously tremendous.
Long saucer to Hainsey. Need to get rid of it.
This game is going to wind down and be close right to the final horn. Each team has tried to enforce their style of play on the other. It's just not happened.
Oh, here's a wrister. Wonderful stop. Trying to go to Pacioretty. Laid on to Drouin.
Breaks free. Save. Shot down the best guy the other team had.
That's unbelievable.
Moving it to Shaw. Montreal's got it in mid-ice.
Enormous hit. He's crushed.
Kirk's made an enormous hit here. You can lead with a goal, a shot, or a hit. This time it's physically as he tries to spark his team.
A punishing hit shuts that one down. That's a good hit off the forecheck.
What a tremendous hit.
Toronto's back in its own end, trying to work forward. Let's the shot fly. Score! They've scrapped back to tie and still a little time left.
I guess at this point, guys, it doesn't really matter what the game looks like. It's back to even square, and we'll find out who's going to take the lead next.
Matthews has delivered the tying goal in this game. Now, can he get the winner? The Canadiens control from the neutral zone. Puck is thrown to Weber.
What a terrific opportunity. Quick wrist shot, and a save.
And coming up is the biggest face-off of this game. We are in the last minute of play, and we're almost ashamed to say it's over. Hopefully it's not. A shot. Marvelous save. A great chance was no chance. Oh, and he is corked yet again.
Open up, drives ahead.
Save! Toronto's marching on halfway up the rink.
Good save there.
Oh, did he ever get mashed? Not on the net.
Oh, man, that's frustrating when you're watching from the bench and a player's got a grade A chance and he doesn't even get a shot on net.
Directing that one to Riley. Up the wing, he keeps on going. Let's it go. Oh, and he misses.
Shots like that are a goalie's worst nightmare.
Good place to shoot from. Save! Shoot.
tremendous back and forth through three periods. Perhaps a decision will come in sudden death overtime.
Present your ticket stub from tonight's game and receive up to 10% off.
Toronto's goal has forced the overtime period. Take a look at it one more time. Who will get the next one? We'll find out when overtime begins in a moment. We have begun sudden death overtime. Nobody scores. Score! The overtime winner! And the players spill over the boards to celebrate. The horn has sounded. The Maple Leafs lost the game. And in overtime, it's like losing a game and a half.
Well, they had their opportunities in regulation, but just come up a little bit short in extra time.
And so ends our telecast of this hockey game tonight. Only one chance to make a good first impression, and one team did. The other team did not, at least according to the scoreboard. For Eddie Olczyk and Ray Ferraro, Mike Emrick saying goodnight.